97.7 DJX, the Ben Davis and Kelly K Show podcast.
Supplying every demand.
On demand.
Setting the bar, small examples, what not to do. Florida, you're making the show. Congratulations. If you can manage to make it through the day without strapping a utility bolt pole that you just stole to the roof of your Camry, then you're doing okay.
I'm sorry, back the Camry up. Why are we taking a pole? What are we going to do with that? Are they hot at the pawn shops? What's happening?
Again, I don't know what it is about light poles in Florida that has everybody all up in arms, but Doug couldn't help himself from WFLA.
Douglas Allen Hatley of Lakeland had this massive utility pole strapped to the roof of his car, taking it to a recycling facility. But when he got to that recycling facility, they say that he couldn't turn it in to recycle the massive pole, that is, because he didn't have proper documentation for it.
Ah, okay.
Ah.
So he's so like
a wooden pole? I guess, or is it a metal pole?
Oh, it's a metal pole. And he's like, hey, I got this. Can I recycle it and turn it in for some money?
How much is that going to be?
Yeah, and they're like, do you have paperwork for this pole that
says this is your pole?
Yeah, that's strapped to your Toyota Camry. Doug didn't have it. And so poor Doug then got arrested and charged with theft as well as dealing in stolen property. So, again,
is this happening a lot in Florida? Are people taking poles? Can I recycle them for money?
This is our second story of the year about someone stealing a light pole out of Florida.
Huh. You know what? I'm kind of impressed because I feel like those poles are anchored pretty well in the ground.
Yes.
Like, I'd like to see the logistics, the video of them like getting it out of the earth.
And then strapping it to the car. Yeah, exactly. So, again, Florida, congratulations. You made the show. If you can manage to make it through the day without strapping a stolen utility pole to the roof of your Camry, you're doing okay.
I mean, let's be real. Doug deserves some kudos if he pulled that off all by himself. That seems like you'd need a crew.
Yeah, you're right.
It looks like Doug just was a solo project. He went through all that effort.
We should be patting Doug on the back and saying, good job, bud.
He's a hard worker. He's putting in the time, right?
He's just using his energy for the wrong reasons. So
yeah, let's refocus the energy. That's all.
There you go. Florida making the show here on 99.7 DJX.